Page 24. The Little Fir Tree. Shetty the magician was returning home when all of a sudden it began to rain. It rained heavily. Shetty looked around for shelter and saw a pretty little fir tree. He ran towards it as fast as he could. Soon the rain stopped. Shetty was happy that he did not get wet. "Thank you. You have been kind to me. I would like to reward you. Ask for 4 wishes and I will grant them," said the magician. Page 25. The sad fir tree had leaves like needles and no birds ever made their nests on it. So it said, "I wish I had green leaves like my other friends." Next morning, its wish was granted. Soon, a goat came along and ate all the green leaves. "Oh dear," said the fir tree. "I wish I had gold leaves, as goats do not eat gold leaves." When the little fir tree woke up the next morning, it was surprised to see gold leaves. "How happy I am," it said. A man came along and stole the gold leaves. "I wish I had glass leaves instead. Men do not steal glass leaves." The next day, its glass leaves shone in the bright sun. "How happy I am," it said. At night, the wind blew woo-woo. All the glass leaves broke. Page 26. "Oh dear," said the fir tree. "I like my old needle-like leaves best, for goats do not eat them. No man can steal them. The wind will do them no harm." The tree went to sleep. When it woke up the next morning, it had all its needles back again. "Oh, I never was so happy," said the little fir tree. New words: pretty, needles, leaves, gold, stole. Page 27. Reading is fun. Tick the correct answer. A. The pretty little fir tree was happy with gold leaves, but option 1. A goat came along and ate them. Option 2. All the leaves got wet in rain. Option 3. A man stole them. B. The fir tree was sad. Option 1. Because it had yellow leaves. Option 2. Because it had needle-like leaves. Option 3. Because it was very short. C. The fir tree was not happy with the gold leaves. Option 1. Because the goats came and ate them. Option 2. A man stole them. Option 3. The gold leaves broke. Page 28. By changing the circled word to its opposite, rewrite these sentences. One has been done for you. I carry a light bag to school every day. In this sentence, light is the circled word. So, the opposite sentence would be, I carry a heavy bag to school every day. B. Rina won the race. In this sentence, one is the circled word. Now write the opposite sentence in the blank space given. C. I love eating vegetables. In this sentence, love is the circled word. Now write the opposite sentence using the opposite of love in the blank space given. D. This glass of milk is full. In this sentence, full is the circled word. Now write the opposite word of full in a sentence in the blank space given. E. The old man is wise. In this sentence, wise is the circled word. Now write the opposite of wise in a sentence in the blank space given. 2. Now give the opposite of the words below by adding un or im. Happy. Blank space. Polite. Blank. Seen. Blank. Proper. Blank. Lucky. Blank. Possible. Blank. Important. Blank. Perfect. Blank. Healthy. Blank. Safe. Blank. Patient. Blank. Pure. Blank. Page 29. 3. Rita loved her dog Sheru. Every day, Sheru would go out of the house and come back himself. But one day, he did not come home. Rita looked everywhere for him. Tears rolled down her cheeks. Sheru was lost. He was nowhere to be found. Rita was crying when she reached home. She got into her bed. All of a sudden, something jumped on her. Can you guess who it was? Rita was very happy. Give the opposites of the words written in blue. Loved. Go out. Come. Everywhere. Down. Lost. Nowhere. Crying. Happy. Please write the opposites of these words in the blank space given. Let's write. 1. Rewrite the passage below using capital letters where necessary. 1. One Saturday afternoon, Amarjeet and his little sister Rani went for a picnic to India Gate. There they saw ducks, water, and their friend Raj. Blank space. 2. Oh dear, said the fir tree, I like my old needle-like leaves best, for goats don't eat them, and no man can steal them. Blank space. Page 30. Let's talk. 1. Look at the picture below. In the yellow box, there are 8 things. You can see 6 of them in the picture. You cannot see the other 2. Write down the 4 things that you can see. Ducks, dog, boy, fountain, mat, girl, tree, flowers, blank space. 2. Look at the picture again. Describe the picture. Page 31. Fun time. 1. Ajit loved flowers. He always wanted to have a garden for himself. Mohan, his friend, gave him an idea. He said, "Why, we can have a garden in a dish." "Ha ha!" Ajit laughed. "A garden in a dish?" "Yes. Dish gardens are tiny gardens planted in a shallow dish. We must first put sand, manure and pebbles in a dish. Plant very tiny plants in it and place the dish on the window sill." 2. Glass breaks easily when it is dropped. Do you think a mud flower pot, a glass spoon, a wooden table, a plastic cup, books, or your plastic water bottle can break easily? Circle the things that can. Spoon, table, flower pot, plastic water bottle, books, cup. Page 32. 3. Which of the following actions would make others happy or unhappy? Respecting elders. Not saying thank you. Being polite. Playing with friends. Visiting a sick friend. Not sharing. Watching television all day. Telling lies. Being greedy. Caring for pets. Getting angry easily. Being honest. Now write the actions that make people happy. Blank space has been given for your answer. Now write actions that make people unhappy. Blank space has been given for your answer. Page 33. Let's listen, read and write. There was a thick jungle with beautiful green trees and birds. Koel was singing happily. Suddenly, she heard someone crying. It was her friend, the peacock. She flew to him and asked, "Why are you crying?"
"I hate myself. I have such ugly feet."
Some things make you feel happy. Some things make you feel sad. Write a poem on the picture. Page 34. Let's make a word tree. This is how you will do it. Take a long green sheet of paper or newspaper. Roll it like this. Hold the roll of paper firmly in one hand and cut 4 slits from the top to halfway down the roll. Still holding the roll of paper firmly, bend back the 4 sections of the cut paper. Pull out the branches. Do this by pulling up the cut sections slowly and carefully from the center of the roll. Write words related to leaves on the trees and make a word tree. Now, make sentences with these words. Page 35. Teacher's page. Unit 2. Poem. Noses. Story. The little fir tree. Themes. Self-esteem and satisfaction. Respecting individuality. The main aim of this unit is to sensitize the child and make her or him feel happy with what she or he is or has. These expressions of inner feelings are not to be judged, labeled, but may only be heard, seen, and shared by you. Give the children practice in observation and conversation. Let them talk freely about different type of faces and noses that they have seen. Bring the shy child into conversation while asking questions. Talk with them about the way they use their eyes, ears, nose, and minds. Develop the child's self-esteem and cultivate children's creativity. In the context of a fast-changing world, it is imperative that we respect the children's wisdom and imagination. How do we behave and see ourselves, and how do others see us? Do they see us as kind, helpful, or funny? Stress the three sides of a person: the one you think you are, the one others think you are, the one you really are. Warm up. If you have a child in your class who you feel is not very confident, invite the little one to sit comfortably and then involve 4 or 5 children to share something they like about her or him as a friend. With exchanges and sharing in this way, you will very soon have a class where children relate to each other and participate in learning. Avoid correcting them when they are speaking. The idea is to build confidence and finally fluency in speaking. Reading time. Step 1. Read the text aloud with voice modulation. Step 2. Let the children read the text along with you. Sharing time. In this unit, involve children with the creative time activity. For example, let them share with you their interest in speaking, writing, drawing, or any other art form or paper activity. They can be encouraged to use this medium to express, who am I? What do I want to be? The activity helps the children to express their thoughts logically. Page 36. They also learn to interact with each other. Divide the class into conversation groups. Help each child to think and talk about what he saw that morning. His father, baby sister, pet, etc. And ask them how they feel. They can illustrate this through pictures which can be displayed in the class. Writing time. Help children improve their handwriting with practice, but guide them by precept and discussion. Handwriting suggestions can be put up on a chart for the class. Some of these can be to A. Make the writing even. B. Begin sentences with capital letters. C. End the sentences with periods or question marks. D. Write the letters carefully on the line. Creative time. Ensure that the children's running handwriting is done in their notebooks. From the spellings that they have learned from this lesson, let them construct meaningful sentences in their notebooks. Try to teach organizational skills. Let children make a poem on their eyes or ears or on the peacock, our national bird, in their notebooks. Introduce the use of and but through oral work to bring out the function of addition and contrast respectively. Language Corner. Let children be given sentences using is or are. Environment. Segregation of class waste paper and food articles into containers of biodegradable and degradable waste can be started in a simple, efficient and environmental friendly manner.